Ladies and gentlemen, please, would you coldly invite Mr. Adam Benarachetti to the stage? Sam, super fucking beast.
It's a compliment.
I tell you what, the fuck is going on with these lights? That's too much. I've been told I should stop drinking, because it can kill you. That's what happened to her in my house, didn't it, mate? She stopped drinking and it killed her. She'd go on a 2-week fucking vodka bender before, and like, Russia were rubbing their hands going, whoa, she's fucking spending some money. That's how Russia deal with everything. People spend money on vodka. That's it. Oh, I can see you all now. That's awesome. Good evening. I forgot why I was up here. Now I remember. Adverts on television amused me so much, it's unbelievable. Did you ever see the on TV for Tenor Lady? Might not be on anymore. I haven't watched TV in a long time. Can't afford TV. Not the TV, the license. I can't afford the license. But I've got a TV. And the advert for me, it fucking amused me so much, was, what's the first thing you notice about me? Is it my long hair? Is it my light that I kick? Is it my long legs? It's certainly not a bladder weakness. It fucking is now! How the fuck's that woman gonna get a date, ever, in her life? She's pissed herself. I've actually come up with my own advert for that. Right. Just imagine, right, everybody has been out in a group of guys and girls. Everybody's been out. And there's always a girl that goes, I need a wee! I need a wee! I need a wee! And a bloke always says, just go. It's alright for men, you can go anywhere! So can you! It's called Tenor Lady! That's an advert I'd watch over and over again, just a tagline underneath it. Tenor Lady, go on, piss yourself! I just spent hours watching that advert. One advert I can't get out of my head is you can sponsor a child for £5 a month. If you flip the channel over, you can sponsor a bear for £3 a month. Which one would you want in a fight? I would have to explain to the nurse in AE why I've got a three-son African suppository, you see. It's all wrong, right? You know the advert, you sponsor a tiger for so much a month or whatever, right? They sponsor a tiger for £3 a month or whatever, right? Somebody bought me that as a present. So basically I had to pay £3 a month for the rest of my life to sponsor a fucking tiger so they could live. I cancelled my subscription. They did not like that one fucking bit. Why are you cancelling your subscription? Because I don't want to pay for this anymore. I said, how is this tiger gonna live in the wild without your money? If it can't live in the wild without my fucking money, it's Mother Nature's way of telling it's a fucking shit tiger. I don't have to pay for that fucking shit. I found out recently. recently as well. You know this, you've got to eat five fruit and veg a day, right? That was all a marketing ploy. It wasn't anything to do with the government or any of that shit. It was a marketing ploy from fruit and veg companies, surprisingly. It's no more true than you can get AIDS bicycling. That's fact. True. Y'all look at me. I tell you what, let's get political for a second. You look like you want to get political. Gaddafi, it looks like Tom Selleck that's had an allergic reaction. He does, he fucking does. Right, now, when they caught Mr. Gaddafi, Colonel Gaddafi, they caught him, bombed him and killed him. Not necessarily in that order. Bombing. Come on. That's a bit much. Yes, he may have fucked up an entire country, but bombing him, it's like bombing him and then killing him. It's not fair, is it? Because I know he said he got caught in crossfire. I'm fucking sure he did get caught in crossfire. Can you imagine this? It makes me laugh. He's like, he's the same as Kurt Crossfire. He was very cross that somebody was firing blanks into his arsehole. Oh, nothing. I would like to hear an impression. Impression?
Yeah.
Anything that anybody shouts out at me, I can say it's Kermit the Frog.
Hey, see, you rock!
Can you say that again?
Cool. Hey, you rock.
You're calling therapy to me.
Hey, Satan, you rock. Motherfucker, I can talk like Kermit the Frog all you fucking want. Squeal like a piggy in this, We're in a bit of a predicament.
Is anybody else? Right. Has anybody else been caught in the problem that, like, your partner wakes up and blames you for the shit that you did in her dream? Has anybody else been through that?
Yeah,
somebody said yeah. I woke up and I looked at my girlfriend and I was like, no. She's there, and she woke up. You cheated on me in my dream. What the fuck? I am not to blame for anything you do in your dream. The worst I can do when I'm asleep is maybe hold you tight, see what a penis looks like as a moustache. That's it. A lot of people here have been through that. Just check. Ah, she's alright. I can't see a fucking thing. So I'm gonna come down here. Good evening. It's not going so well for me tonight, is it, Lou?
Ah, it's great.
Oh, good. Like to see it. I learned an impression earlier on in the day. And it was Barney the Dinosaur. But all I learned to say was Barney the Dinosaur was Barney on school's wheelchairs, just for fun! Mental. It's true. Look at this, he's looking at me like, you should tell a joke now. I'll tell you a really good story, this is a true story as well. Has anyone done Tesco's delivery shopping? Not a single fucking person here has done Tesco. Have you heard about the fact that Tesco's deliver shopping?
Yeah.
Yeah, alright. somebody has to pick them orders. Unfortunately, I know a friend who picks them orders. And then they got an order through for aubergines. He had no fucking idea what an aubergine was. Not a fucking clue. He said of asking somebody or looking it up, he changed the order. Do you want me to change it to? Tampons. I'm not joking. Can you imagine the delivery guy's face when he turned up at the fucking house? I was like, yeah, we've changed the order. We didn't have any aubergine, so we changed it to, change it to tampons. Enjoy your moussaka. That's a true story. Apart from the delivery guy. Delivery guy, yeah? Delivery guy. No, that's not it. So, does anybody know who James Hetfield is?
Yeah.
I heard somebody there. James Hetfield, for those of you, that's really echoey in here. For those of you who don't know who James Hetfield is, he's the lead singer of the Tiger. And I've always thought it must be really difficult for him to have sex. Because you can't help thinking that he performed while he was performing. So, like, all I can picture in my head is, and not that I do it often. I might do it a little bit. Like an earthquake. Ah, to see clear. Is it you? Is it the bill? I'm very coitus with you. Yeah. Ride the lightning, bitch. I like to think that's exactly how it goes. Nobody's enjoying this, are we? Let's play a game. There's a step there. Just in case. You might not know. There's a step. Far too drunk for this shit. Let's play a game. What do you do?
I work in the theatre.
You work in the theatre? That's awesome. I can't really make a joke out of that. That's bullshit. Thanks. Thanks. What you've done is make this night worse for everybody else! It's already going pretty fucking terribly for me.
She also works at prep. Or do you work at prep? I make some.
Ooh, you work at prep. My girlfriend goes to prep to get sandwiches for homeless people. It is, isn't it? It's really nice. Yeah. She doesn't just let me in the house. Fucking homeless. Bastard. She's not here tonight. She's fucking marvellous. Means I can drink as much as I like, which I clearly have done, and he can look at me dead in the eyes and say, this is really fucking echoing. I don't like it here though, I don't like it here. I was on a bus not so long ago. I overheard a conversation. It was, what's the worst thing your parents can say to you? Does anybody have any idea what the worst thing you, what they can, what's the worst thing your parents can say to you?
You're adopted.
You're adopted. It's pretty good.
Give you sex advice.
That's also good.
Where are your brother and sister?
Where are your brother and sister? He knows my mum and dad. Let's just not. They came to the conclusion the worst thing your parents can say to you is.
No Santa Claus?
I'm very disappointed in you. Now I've heard worse. Tonight, I've heard worse. My mum once said to me, I told her I was coming home, and she said, well, I have to give us a couple of days, because your grandma's been staying, we need to get a sex swing out of your bedroom. Everybody looks disgusted, right? This has not gone well for me so far, has it? Let's be fair. Now, I love my grandma, right? And I should have realised from a young age that she was maybe a little bit, racist. The fact that she took me into to sleep and did like eagle covers. That's true. There's a couple of grins there going, she's just joking. No, fucking hell, you don't know my grandma. She's the goose step to Lidl. Lidl's my favourite fucking shop in the world, right? You don't get this anymore, right? Lidl used to be able to get a fucking big basket of cans that had no fucking label on it at all. For a penny. What the fuck's that shit done? For a penny. You could get pink charms or dog food. Doesn't matter, it was a meal for two, either way. Right, I'll tell you what. I'll leave you with something, because this hasn't gone well. Let's be fair. It's not gone well. He's put his call. He's really good. You need a bus. I've got another story about a bus. Can I hear it before I go? You don't have time. That's awful.
It's a lack.
It's ironic. It's not ironic, is it? But no, you said you need a bus. I've got another story about a bus. Why can't you just wait? It's 5 minutes of your life. You'll never get it back. But it's 5 minutes early, your bus can wait. This is important shit. You've come here for free. You listen to me. He can't even put his fucking jacket on. That's why he's staying here to listen to my next story about the bus. Wait, no, his sleeves are in and that's it. He's gone. What's your name? Dan. Dan, the man that needs to get a bus. I'll remember you for the rest of my life. Until I have another point. Which is going to happen in a minute. That's it. He looks so scared. Everything I say to him, he's like, what are you going to say? I'm not that funny. As everybody else has found out. He was waiting. Anyway. Goodbye, Dan. Nice to meet you.
Bye, Dan.
Dan gets a smattering of applause. When I leave the stage, people will be cheering like fuck. Just because I'm off. I want to go on for so long, but you're just not engaging. Let's play again. There's a step there. Every single time I've come down there, I've... twice. Nah, you've already played again. I can't ask you, you're my brother. That's all I've got! Stop this. Oh, fuck. I'll leave you with it, like, just one thing. Carlsberg don't do job centres. If they did, it'd still be fun.
You.
Job centres. This is going well, baby. I was on the dinner the other day. I found a sex toy for both men and women. Right? This is true. can't change any mature. She's laughing at me. It's not. This is true. Right? It's called Fuck Me, Fuck You Computer. True story, right? Now, the woman's part of it, I don't have a problem with it, because it's like, it's just a stick that sort of does. You know, somebody must have all sucked in here, eh? It's the male version I've got a problem with, which is, it's just a hole in your desktop. Now, in my experience, ejaculate on electronics. That's never been the best thing in the world. I once came on a calculator in WH Smith and it was just fucking pandemonium. It just went mental. I'll leave you here with words of wisdom from my grandma, which was fuck 'em. Cheers.